The figure shows part of a fence. It is made of rectangles and semicircles of different sizes. Find the perimeter of the fence. Leave your answer in term of pi. So we know that this fence is actually made of rectangles and semicircles of different sizes. The difficulty comes in because the circumference of the circles are all different, right? And due to the different diameter. But we can see from here that this circle, this semicircle, matches with this semicircle to form one circle. This semicircle would match with this semicircle to form one circle, while this semicircle would actually partner with this semicircle to form one full circle. So an example that I can give you is, okay, first we need to know how to find circumference of a circle. Circumference of a circle is equals to pi times d. So if the diameter of a circle is 2, the circumference will be pi times 2, which gives us 2 pi. If its diameter is 3, then it will be pi times 3, which gives us 3 pi. And if it's pi times 4, which means that diameter is 4, it will give us 4 pi. So the total perimeter of the three different circles will be equivalent to 2 pi plus 3 pi plus 4 pi, which gives us a total of 9 pi. And this is actually equivalent to a total of pi times 2 plus 3 plus 4, which is equal to pi times 9, which is also equal to 9 pi. Now, following this pattern, first we will use 8 meters to minus 2 meters. So 8 minus 2 would give us 6 meters. 6 meters is actually the length of this plus this. So to find the diameter of the three circles, we still need to use 6 meters divided by 2, which gives us 3 meter. Now, following the earlier concept that if even though the diameters of the circles can be different, which is can be 2, 3, and 4, I just need to use a pi times the total diameter and I'll get the circumference of the circle. So I know the total diameter of the three circles is equivalent to 3 meters. So to find the circumference of the three circles, I just need to use pi times 3, which is equivalent to 3 pi meter. So this is the circumference of circles. The next step, since the question is asking us to find the perimeter, I will need to add up all the length together and the circumference of the circles. So the length of that we can actually see from here is, so to find perimeter, we just need to use 2 meters, which is here, plus 1.3 meter, which is here, plus 8 meters represented here, plus another 1.3 meter, and the total circumference of the circle, which is this, plus 3 pi. So this will give us a total of 12.6 plus 3 pi meter.